Hello, this is Marco Melandri.
It's Sylvain Guintoli.
I'm John McGuinness.
I'm Tom Sykes.
I'm Neil Hodgson.
I'm Leon Cammier.
I'm Nick Sanders.
I'm Jonathan Ray.
I'm Brady Smith.
And you're watching Motorcyclenews.com.
Okay, so it's February in 2013. It's a little bit cold, but we've got Triumph's new Daytona 675 and their old Daytona 675. We've got a 2 mile runway, we've got plenty of corners, we've got dry roads, so we're going to answer some important questions. Is the new one quicker than the old one? And is the new one got more mid-range and better brakes and better handling? So I'm off to go get my levers on, start getting a bit cold. Bruce has got some speed testing to do. Off you go, Bruce. Okay, so we just bought the new Daytona down to BSD Performance. As you can tell by the bike, it's done around 500 road miles and you've already seen all the speed testing at Bruntenthorpe. So what we're going to do now is put the bike on the dyno and find out what the actual back wheel performance is. So you've seen the bike's been speed tested, and interestingly the old bike is actually a little bit quicker than the new bike. But that's more down to the gearing, because don't forget the new bike is one tube smaller on the front sprocket than the old bike. So an acceleration, 0 to 60, 0 to 120 and even 0 to 140, the new bike is quicker. Also, when you roll the bike on through the gears from 30 miles an hour in fourth gear, for example, again the new bike is quicker. We've had both bikes on the dyno. The new bike has a much smoother linear torque curve and power curve and produces a few more horsepower at the top end. So that's all the facts and figures, but what are they actually like to ride in the real world? Obvious changes: the mirrors are slightly better on the new bike. You've now got a fuel gauge rather than a fuel light on the new bike. The new bike is slightly roomier. Bars are a little bit higher. Chassis wise, the steering is more precise, it turns a little easier, holds the line better, and the suspension's a little bit more compliant. For you race boys, you've got a big air induction, so it's going to be easier to tune the engine to get more air in. Bigger the lungs, the more horsepower you're going to have. The biggest problem Triumph have is the old bike is still an excellent bike. I did around 400 miles on the old bike and still really liked it. I'm unsure whether I'd trade up if I had the old bike to the new bike, but what I can say for sure is the new bike is an excellent bike. It looks good, it's quicker, it's got more torque, it's got more power, it's got a more precise chassis. But the problem is, the old bike is still a good one too.